green argument now, the main green argument for nuclear power is the climate one, that this is basically a zero carbon source of baseload electricity, which is what you need to run cities and so on. And the world's now half cities and it's headed toward 80% urban people. So we're going to want a lot of that kind of electricity. And it either comes from coal or from nuclear. And the coal waste, which is hundreds of thousands of tons of carbon dioxide that goes into the atmosphere, is tremendously deleterious in terms of climate, plus all the other stuff that comes out of there, mercury and so on. Whereas the waste from nuclear is very limited in size and in scale. It's heavy, but you put it in these dry cask storage containers out back of the parking lot at the reactor sites, and there's not very much of it. It doesn't add up very quickly. You're getting a lot of juice out of it. And then and it's relatively easy to either put in the ground. I think the best site for it is in New Mexico at what's called the Waste Isolation Pilot Plant that's already been dealing with nuclear waste for 10 years. Or leave it where it is for 50, 100 years while we think about whether we want to either reprocess it the way the French do or completely burn it in the fourth generation faster reactors that are very comfortable treating that waste as fuel. I think the U.S. has done more harm to itself by worrying about terrorism than the terrorists ever did. And so, you know, we bend everything to think in terms of, oh my gosh, what would a terrible terrorist do with this? And, you know, it's been quite a long time now since there's been that kind of attack. It would take an exceptionally stupid terrorist to try to do something harmful with what goes on with nuclear power. One, the sites are, you know, isolated, incredibly well guarded. The stuff of the way it's transported is very, very safe, and they've run, you can see images, videos of trains running into the containers and no bad thing happening and so on. And one environmentalist said to me, well, you know, you could you could get a shaped charge and blow a hole in that container and get at that spent fuel. And you have to say, okay, and then what? no bad thing has happened yet. It's just there with a hole in it. You want to go deal with it? It's too hot. It'll hurt you. And, you know, you're off in the bush somewhere. It's science fiction to try to imagine tricky ways that terrorists might do bad things with nuclear as it's used in nuclear power. You can find lots more scary things to do, as real terrorists really do, with many other parts of the infrastructure. It's an electrical grid with various gases like chlorine gas and so on, natural gas that are moved around in compressed form. These are much more vulnerable. But I think the question of what would terrorists do with nuclear power stuff is one of the ways we try to persuade ourselves not to take this seriously. And environmentalists are always looking for something of, oh, it's too expensive, therefore we can't do it. Even though wind is incredibly expensive, but that doesn't stop us from doing it. And it's fine. I'd love to see lots of wind. Or, oh gosh, there's a problem with the nuclear waste, therefore we can't do it. And it's a very prejudiced, I think, ideological set of arguments that emerge. But I wound up, in this book I just finished, having to go through every single one of the objections and say, well, you know, let's look at it realistically, pragmatically, you know, ideology aside for a minute. And, you know, how does it play out in those terms? And I'm persuaded, I used to be against nuclear power, kind of in a knee-jerk mode, as I look through all of the details of the alternatives with coal, how nuclear actually works, the prospects of the next generation reactors that are coming along. Looks to me like, in terms of climate and in terms of everything else, nuclear is a good thing to expand. It's obviously going to be just part of what we do about energy, and it still doesn't add up. So we are looking at serious climate problems, frankly, no matter what we do. And that's another issue that I'm trying to get environmentalists off this kind of Al Gore, don't worry, we'll all get jobs and, you know, do a few of the right things and wave our hands really fast and the climate problem will go away. I just don't see it happening that way. I think that environmentalists kind of grasp at straws a little bit with wind and with solar. They're absolutely right about efficiency and they're cutting back on the excessive and stupid use of energy has a long way to go. And so, for example, the Chinese were saying, well, you know, they're now emitting more greenhouse gases than the U.S. well, per whole country, but per capita, they emit 1/6 of the greenhouse gases we do. So we have a long way to come down to where they are. And they're probably going to go up a bit from where they are just because they're getting out of poverty. So those things are right and good. What I think we're just realizing is the size of the footprint, as it's called, of both wind and solar. A typical 1 gigawatt nuclear plant is maybe a third of a square mile. And a 1 gigawatt solar powered plant is about 25 square miles of bulldozed desert. And as a protector of desert, I don't like that trade-off very much. It's something we're discovering in California now as various solar projects are going forward, and they've put dibbies on 1,000 square miles of Southern California. They want to basically doze flat and put these solar farms on. So I'm all for solar on rooftops and for new solar technology that can put it on the streets and paint and anywhere that you can somehow turn sunlight into electricity. I think that's great. But to imagine that there's no hard trade-offs is an illusion. And that's going to keep happening. We've been here before. Back in the 50s and 60s, when, again, in California, we had a lot of hydroelectric dams coming in, and the Sierra Club said, this is unacceptable, and nuclear power is just coming on, and for a few years there, the Sierra Club said, nuclear power is better than dams. Then they changed their mind about that. But actually, I think they were right the first time.